We're now joined by Colts radio host Matt Taylor. And Matt, what a wild Sunday. I think every Colts fans lost their fingernails. That was a nervous Sunday trying to get into this playoff party.
I mean, even from the time you woke up, you knew that the 1 o'clock windows were going to impact the Colts. And then the 4:25 game between the Colts and the Jags. And then after that, simultaneously watching the Titans and Texans game. So the Colts end up beating the Jaguars, Chris. And then at Lucas Oil Stadium after the game, they throw on the Jumbotron, the other AFC South game that impacts the winner of the division. They hit the upright. The ball goes in. The Colts are literally feet and inches away from, you know, hosting a playoff game, being the number four seed at Lucas Oil Stadium. Now they're the 7 seed going on the road, having to play a really tough, really hot Buffalo team. That's been 2020. I mean, you're talking about the AFC South, or I should say the conference as a whole, the entire AFC. Every team has at least 11 wins. It's just crazy the amount of parity. This is setting up to be, I think, the most fun and entertaining and competitive playoffs we've seen in a long, long time.
All right, Matt, the good thing is the Colts have found a running game and they'll be able to play off of that, we hope. The bad thing is, when are they going to put together 60 minutes and a complete game? Once they do that, they can be so dangerous. They can beat anybody, couldn't they?
Yeah, I agree with you. I think, you know, not to cop out, but this is the NFL. It's really hard. It's really hard to win 11 games, which the Colts just did. Now, I think if you look back at a 16-game schedule, I think maybe once or twice you can say we put a full, complete, all three phases playing well, clicking at the same time type of a game. It's hard. You're going to go through stretches. You're going to go through lulls. And to your point, you're exactly right. The Colts have gone through that these last couple of weeks. They let a 17-point lead slip away in Pittsburgh, and then they were up 20-0 on the Jaguars, where they could have just kind of put their foot on the throat of Jacksonville. They didn't give Jacksonville credit. They came back into that game. You know, they had lost 14 straight, and they didn't give up. You know, they were still playing for something. They were still hungry. I mean, they had the ball four different times in the fourth quarter with a chance to go down and take the lead in that game. The Colts defense got the job done, but we all know we're not going to confuse Jacksonville's offense with that of Buffalo's or Kansas City or any other offense you're going to see in the playoffs. So it is concerning. You got to get it fixed. And those lulls and those periods of time where you're not clicking, you can't afford those in a playoff game where the margin for error is even smaller than it has been in the last couple of games.
Well, this Buffalo offense, talking about clicking on all cylinders, they're scoring at an alarming rate. What do the Colts need to do to slow things down? Because we've seen the pass defense break down a bit. Pass rush has got to be ultimate for the Colts here in this game, isn't it?
The pass rush is huge. I think run defense is major. You know, the Colts on paper, Chris, they do things well that you need to do in order to have success in January, right? They run the ball well. You know, for the season, they're 11th in rushing, but in the last 5 games, they're even better than that. They're 3rd in the NFL in rushing over the last 5, averaging almost 170 yards. So Jonathan Taylor, this offensive line, they've really got their act together. They're clicking and peaking at the right time. And then defensively, you got to slow down the run, right? You got to control the line of scrimmage on both sides of the ball. And to your point, the Colts have given up. They've lagged in the last couple of weeks. The passing game, the passing numbers have ballooned up. But one thing that you can say about this defense all season long is you can't run on them. You know, with DeForest Buckner and Darius Leonard and Justin Houston, Grover Stewart. I mean, the only team that's had any sort of success running the ball on the Colts since Matt Eberflus has been here are the Tennessee Titans, right? And they don't have – the Buffalo Bills do not have Derrick Henry coming up on Saturday. I mean, we looked it up the other day. The Colts are giving up only 65 yards rushing in the last 5 games. And they're number 2 for the season in terms of slowing down the rush. That hasn't happened. The Colts haven't had a top 5 rushing defense since 1971, Chris. So they are legit. They're playing well. And again, DeForest Buckner has made all the difference in the world. And so again, I think if you run the ball well and slow down the run in this game, you give yourself a great chance to win.
All right. Give me your take on playoff pressure. We heard head coach Frank Reich saying, "No one expects us to win. We're kind of playing with house money. It's all on Buffalo." The Bills haven't had a home playoff game since 96, haven't won a playoff game in even longer time. The pressure's on the Bills, isn't it?
Well, you're talking about a fan base up there that's starving. I mean, to your point, 1995 was their last playoff win. 96 was the last time they could congregate and watch a home playoff game. They've lost 6 straight playoff games. You're talking about the third longest playoff drought in the NFL. And so they're going to be hyped. They're going to be ready to go. That being said, they're the number two seed. The pressure is all on them. They're 13-3. They won the AFC East. All of these things are kind of going in their favor. Plus, of all the playoff games this weekend, in terms of the odds, the odds makers out in Vegas have them as a 7 or 8 point advantage in this game. That's the highest of any wild card game. So I completely agree. I mean, the Colts are going in here with house money. They feel like all the pressure's on the other sideline. They're going to be playing. They're going to be feeling loose. They're going to be playing free. And they're just going to go out there and hopefully they ball out and kind of stun a lot of people and advance to the next round of the playoffs and take on another juggernaut, as you say, in the Kansas City Chiefs.
All right, lastly, Matt, the ultimate key, what is the one thing that the Colts absolutely have to do if they're going to win this game and move on to face Kansas City?
Yeah, it sounds cliche. I mean, this could probably apply to every game, but Chris, they can't turn the ball over. They just can't do it. You know, Phillip Rivers has been really good in the last 5 or 6 weeks of taking care of the football. And you're talking about in five losses this year for the Colts, they have 9 turnovers. Okay, so it's not brain science to kind of figure out why the Colts have come up short in some of these games. In the NFL, especially in playoff football, when you're talking about equal footing, you're talking about all great teams this time of year, you can't give them any extra possessions. You can't turn the football over. I would say turnovers, and then you have to be good inside the red zone. Cash in inside the 20, get 7s instead of 3. Because this is a team, as we talked about in Buffalo, I mean, they're scoring almost 47 points per game in the last 3. So they've got the ability to put up a lot of points. You have to match them when you can inside the 20-yard line.
It's not brain science, Matt. I'm going to have to remember that. That's Colts radio host Matt Taylor. Thanks for the time. Call a good game this weekend.
Appreciate it. Thank you very much.